Our objective is to provide the PACAF air crew member 8 to 10 simulated combat sorties every year. And we do that in an environment that includes the most dynamic air-to-air and surface-to-air threats available anywhere in the world.
Radar threat bands help train air crews in electronic warfare. The radar operator locates incoming aircraft on his screen and attempts to electronically shoot them down. Early in the exercise, the kill ratio is quite high, but the pilots learn fast. By the second week of Cope Thunder, the fighters are extremely effective.
I'll put the PACAF fighter pilot up against anybody in the world.
The A-10 school we have here is the only active duty training unit of its kind in the Air Force.
Good afternoon, gentlemen. Welcome to Davis-Monthan Air Force Base. I'm Captain John Boyd, and I'll be one of your instructors. Over the next 4 months while you're here, we'll teach you how to fly and fight in the A-10, which is the first aircraft specifically designed for close air support of Army operations. We'll cover such subjects as...
Gonna set up for the target run. Gas is 8 over 12. Engines look good.
Unlike an RTU or a training unit for any of the other fighter aircraft, the A-10 community is a little different. The A-10 does not have a two-seat capability. He'll have about 6 to 8 hours of simulator time. Therefore, when a student flies the A-10, the first time he takes it up, he's solo. So our role as an instructor becomes a little bit more complex sometimes because we're placed in the position of trying to evaluate his performance while flying a totally separate aircraft.
Well, aside from flying, I consider the instructors the best part of this program because they're really motivated to teach us how to fly. The instructor that you fly with is flying off of you on your wing, or you're flying on his wing. Therefore, we are totally in control of our aircraft and what happens. So if something does go wrong, then it is up to us to get back on the ground.
The biggest advantage of being an instructor pilot in the A-10, as I see it, is that when we instruct a student on how to fly the A-10, we also get to fly. So let's say, for example, on a surface attack ride, the student's gonna go out, drop some bombs, and shoot the gun, of course. We're gonna be instructing him on how to do it and how to improve his scores. But in addition to that, while we're instructing, we also get to drop and to shoot. So our continuity and our training continues even though we're serving primarily as an instructor pilot for most of the flights at Davis-Monthan. Lieutenant Gingras, today's mission will be SAT-7 out of a series of 10 surface attack tactical rides. In keeping with the syllabus, this will be a high threat sortie. We'll be working on the East TAC range with two IPs, Alpha and Bravo, running in from Alpha first. Remember, it's critical that you depart right over the IP itself, be at altitude and on speed. Fence check complete, ready for chaff and flare. You're actually going to be leading the departure from the IP today while I'll be in chase.
It's a fun aircraft to fly. It's a great mission. You get to drop bombs and actually put ordnance on a target every day that we fly.